everyone. I am Teresa, and this is day two that I am in school this week. And the last chapter I read you was chapter 11 of Amelia, Bedelia on the Job, book 9. So today I'll read you chapter 12. Chapter 12, tossing out ideas to kick around. Once lunch has been cleared away, Sandy handed out paper and scattered markers in the middle of the table. Okay, said Sandy, we've been talking about work and our jobs. Now we'd like to hear from you. How can we improve things? What are you hoping to find in a job? What sort of business would you start? Write down what you're thinking or feeling. Toss out a bunch of ideas so we can kick them around. Will they get hurt? Asked Amelia and Bedelia. Will you throw them out?
This is Amelia and Bedelia and one of her friends throwing popcorn in the air and kicking it. These are colored pencils or markers. This is Amelia Bedelia inside a giant head with popcorn pieces, throwing them on the ground to her friends, and they're kicking it.
Yeah, said Angel. Ms. Shock says that good ideas are fragile and need to be protected. Like a young plant, said Holly, or a newborn, said Heather. You wouldn't kick those around, would you? Said Amelia Bedelia. Of course not, said Sandy. Pardon my jargon. Tossing out ideas and kicking them around is how we describe sharing our thoughts and ideas and working together to improve them. Angel, I'll be looking for a report on the difference between jargon and slang next week, said Ms. Shock. Don't hold back, said Sandy. No idea is too wild or crazy. It may spark another idea from someone else. You just never know. Your idea should be outside the box. Whoops! She covered her mouth with her hands. There I go again. More business jargon. I have to go check my messages, but I'll be back in a few minutes to see. But Amelia Bedelia was no longer listening. A curious look had come over her face. It was the look she got whenever she had a great idea, an urgent idea, an idea so bright that it flashed through her brain super fast, and she could not wait one more second to put it down on her paper.
This is a newborn baby with flowers around it. This is a popcorn piece flying out of a box. And this is Amelia Bedelia crossing her arms, winking her eye.
Amelia Bedelia was drawing so furiously that she barely noticed Sandy leaving the room or Ms. Shock circling the table. She drew four large boxes, one in each corner of the paper. Inside each box, she wrote two letters, BP, OP, PP, and CP. Then, in the center of the page, she drew a circle so big that it nearly touched the corners of every box. In the center of the circle, she wrote two more letters, IP, around the lower rim of that circle. She printed, thinking outside the box. Amelia Bedelia drew as fast as she could, cramming as much detail as she could fit inside the circle. There were cafe tables and chairs, a coffee bar, and an old-fashioned ice cream soda shop, the way she imagined it. There were gardens to grow healthy vegetables. There was a play structure made of huge industrial parts. There was a stage where people could perform, spaces to display things, and smaller areas with couches so people could sit and talk. Amelia Bedelia leaned back in her chair to admire her handiwork. Then she made the mistake of looking to see what her classmates were doing. She spotted a lot of lists with numbered ideas. She had only had one idea. She felt a little foolish. Amelia Bedelia shook her head and folded her drawing first in half, then in quarters.
This is a pen. And these are a lot of paper that have ideas on it. Numbered ideas on it. This is Amelia Bedelia with the letters PP, BP, OP, and CP. And this says thinking outside the box. And this is a slide and poles. This is a picture. This is the old-fashioned soda shop that Amelia Bedelia imagined it would look like. This is a couch with people on it talking. These are table and chairs, and two people are sitting at one of them. Then she scrunched it up with both hands into a ball. Glancing over her shoulder, she tossed her idea over her head toward the waste paper basket by the door. Her weighted up idea missed the basket, bounced off the wall, and rolled across the floor. "Hey," said Clay, "Amelia Bedelia just tossed out an idea." Cliff jumped up and began dribbling her idea between his feet as if it was a soccer ball. "Look," he said, "I'm kicking an idea around." "Goofball," said Clay, reaching down to grab the scrunched up paper. He pretended to dribble away from the trash can and then whipped around the exhausted a jump shot that sent the paper ball arching up, 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 and straight into Miss Shock's outstretched hand. This is Cliff dribbling the idea and kicking it. This is Amelia Bedelia's idea flying. This is someone throwing Amelia Bedelia's idea. And this is Clay throwing Amelia Bedelia's idea over the table and into Miss Shock's hand.
Okay, bye everyone. I'll read you chapter 13 next time.